Hey, how y'all doing? Welcome back to Major Slack Videos, your first opportunity tactical gaming, and this is the Far Cry 3 Hardcore Ramble Run. This is where I beat the game with no purchases, no skills, and no crafting on master difficulty setting, and I gotta beat the game in under 7 hours. Alright, so here we go. This video is gonna be action-packed to make up for the last video. We're gonna jam off 3 missions in this video. Kick the Hornet's Nest, a man named Hoyt, and saving Oliver, all of which are really tough missions normally, but under my rules of engagement, they're gonna be extra tough. And I'm looking for a hang glider so I can fly over to the drug fields. There's usually two hang gliders, one of two hang gliders to choose from here. One of them has spawned, that's very convenient. And up and away. Now, a lot of you were wondering, how the hell am I going to do this mission with my rules of engagement here? Actually, I mentioned that before. If you blow all of the explosive barrels in the drug fields, you're guaranteed to burn down 3 of them right there and then. I forget how many there are. We'll count them together right now as I do the mission. And we'll find out exactly how many there are, because I know I get them all. And I do actually manage to burn down three of the drug fields right away just doing that. Another frequently asked question, is this commentary dubbed? Yes, of course it's dubbed. There's no way I could play at this pace and do live commentary. I tried it once and I failed miserably. This Ramble Run requires all of my attention on the gameplay. So yeah, all this commentary is going to be dubbed. It's going to be dubbed throughout. Now I'm doing the same thing. I just put the hang glider in what I like to call stealth bomber mode. Just dip it down a bit to increase the airspeed and jam on over there, doing that again. Now I want to just like drop right down near the dock and plunk into the water. It's a nice landing right there. Same tactic as the master difficulty run. This is what the C4 is for. Chuck some C4 on the dock to sneaky out there. And now it's going a little different than the master difficulty run. I'm going the opposite direction. Instead of going clockwise, I'm going counterclockwise around the drug fields, because I've discovered since that there's a lot better cover if you go counterclockwise around. All right, and this is something I discovered out of necessity. Yeah, necessity is the mother of invention. So you can just get past this part here. Okay, so let's count up the explosive barrels, find out once and for all how many there are. Because I get them all. One.
That's a lot of weed.
Yeah, it's nice juicy. Two. Three. Four. There's one right there, Slag. Five. Now I'm just kind of racing across behind these rocks, which provide beautiful cover, much better cover than the other side, than that grassy ridge on the other side. Reloading. Never.
That's one down.
Six. Seven. Eight. I think there's one over there now. Nine. 10, and I'm out. But this is gonna do it. I'm positive this is gonna do it. So there you go, 10 explosive barrels.
Awesome.
Blow all those, and you'll burn down 3 drug fields, guaranteed. So I'm out of ammo, you know, because, like, that's all I can carry in my sniper rifle.
10. Number 3.
So there you go, 3 drug fields burned down. Now you race around to the other side. And this is kind of like what I call the auxiliary drug field here. And in this little shack here is a flamethrower. And what I wanted to do, see, this is what I kind of flubbed. See, my sniper rifle disappeared. I wanted to reload the sniper rifle first with the ammo there and then grab the flamethrower. But I kind of fucked up and the game disappeared my sniper rifle. So I'm just going to have to rely on the guns for sale machine reloading my sniper rifle, which I think it does. Simply the same way that plants respawn and stuff like that. I think that, you know, your ammo kind of respawns in those machines if you leave a weapon in there and then fast travel away. So here's how we get the fourth and fifth drug fields. Just a little dab, do you? Spritz it up with some fire. Keep the cover. Do you think? Just because everything is on fire and smoking away. Nah, nah, everything's fine. Don't worry about it. And I'm surprised I didn't have to deal with the dog. Because usually there's a dog in that auxiliary drug field, and usually when I'm racing around to get the flamethrower, the dog gets right on my arse.
Number four goes up in smoke.
Okay, so that last drug field that I just set fire to burned. Got one more here, and you can sneak around here. Usually they're all milling around in the middle looking for you. Give that one a little spritz, and that's it. That's all you need to do. Switch over to the C4. As soon as we get the notification that the fifth one has burned, blow the dock, and the boat's going to be there, and that'll complete the mission. See, there's the boat. Just wait for the notification that the fifth drug crop has burned. No, I'm sitting there thinking, uh-oh. Did I set fire to it enough? Did it really burn? Uh-oh, do I have to go back?
Number five and was totally worth it. That's
blow
one
the boat.
Down. That's it.
Wait for
I'm
the notification that the mission is a success, and we are out of here. Now, I want a different loadout, I believe. I know what I want to do. I'm going to a mannequin town. I want to do a... a body armor run. So I'm taking on the PKM. This is the man named Hoyt coming up. This mission is pure hell on the Rambo run. Pure hell. Because you've got barely any ammo, and your choice of weaponry is really... it's pretty slim. So I'm taking on the PKM. That's the most ammo I can load up with at this point. And I'm going to do a body armor run, race up just north of Mannequin Town, grab that body armor that always respawns. And that's all I'm going to have with me to take on that mission and escort Rongo through some minefields. Yeah, pure hell. I had to practice this one. I think this is the one where I trashed the car. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I did this just for shits and giggles. And go boom boom. There we go. Yeah, that was very satisfying. Alright, feel better, Slack?
Yes, I do.
So grab a med kit and the body armor, and that's it. Back to Bad Town. We're going to do the same thing. Gonna grab those hang gliders, and you can actually fly those hang gliders all the way to the mission location. First have to hook up with Willis.
I love the flamethrower.
Those Germans, what can I say? They know how to light stuff on fire. Got you an earpiece.
Thanks. Hey, you ever go out on recon with your guys?
There's a reason I have the American flag in here. In here, there's society, there's order. Out there, the jungle, the synapses in our brains go dark little by little. You forget where you're from, who you are.
Yeah. So, what about my friend Oliver?
I've almost burst this thing wide open. I can feel it. By the way, you're getting popular.
Lovely weather we're having.
My boss, are you planning a parade?
That's why I love you, Voss. You make me laugh. Everything in business is so goddamn serious. But you, sir, what about Snow White?
You know what? I don't give a fuck about him. I don't give a fuck.
Really? Then why am I here? Once you've got the ransom money, his friends are gonna be sold like that. I shot his older brother. I did what you wanted with his younger brother. He's my sister. She's inking that white boy. I don't give a fuck about your family. It is by my grace that your head isn't impaled on the antenna of my car. Therefore, I would like it if you gave a fuck about Jason Brody.
Okay, Hoyt. Okay. All right.
Fantastic. dick. Ah, I'm really loving this weather. What's the name of that village down the road? Barristown? Bunch of native sympathizers. They stole the transportation manifest that's close to my heart. I'd like to pay them a visit. Nice to see you, Voss.
Better make your way to Barristown.
I bet Oliver's on the manifest. Who has it?
I'll tell you when you get there. I gotta keep on working. See yourself out.
There you go. So we got the next mission. A man named Hoyt. A.K.A. a mission called Hell. Okay, so, yeah.
They don't want you to know. They don't want you to know.
Alright, so first order of business is to get that hang glider again. Let's backdoor this jet ski. Take it to the exact same place I took before. Took the hang glider before. There's two hang gliders here. So, get a pretty good chance that one of them's gonna spawn, and the one that I want to spawn has spawned. This one right there. And you can fly either of these two hang gliders all the way to the mission location. Now, two things. This is kind of a tricky flight. First of all, I'm going to dip the hang glider down, put it into stealth bomber mode, as I like to call it. Just a little bit, because you don't want to get too close to the road. Now, you got to fly right over the road, okay? If you fly out over the water too much, what happens is the game will steal your altitude, okay? It just decides, no, you can't fly over the water, and you're just gonna like lose altitude rapidly, and you're just crashing into the water. Okay, so try to fly right over the road as much as you can. Okay, that's number one. Number two, when you get over the mission location, don't fly inland, because what's gonna happen is the exact opposite. There's this strange updraft, which you can't use to your advantage. Okay, I tried using that to my advantage. Okay, now you can fly out over the water. Okay, it's safe. Okay, once you get to this point here, it's safe to fly over the water. But if you fly to your left there, okay, over like the rice fields and whatnot, there's this updraft. Well, I mean, like a big updraft to fly right up in the air. Okay, and it'll screw up your landing if you try to land. Okay, so usually I like to fly like hook around, make this big hooking kind of flight, and hook into that little hut there. Now what happens here is I made a crash landing, and I just made it by the skin of my teeth because I was so worried about the updraft, because this has screwed me up a couple times. I come in, I'm lining up a nice beautiful landing, and all of a sudden this mysterious updraft just flies me right up in the air, and just as I let go of the hang glider, I get flown right up in the air. So I made it by the skin of my teeth, but I made it! The only thing I'm really worried about is that I had to use up one of my precious med kits.
Points
so.
Here.
Wait until he leaves. Otherwise, he'll make chicken chow mein out of your friend.
I want it to be clear that anyone who helps those savages out in the woods will end up like our friends here. Is my point coming across? You! Run!
See a guy in red scratch?
In the middle of the mine.
Point made! Have fun, boys!
That's our man. Go in and extract him.
Are you nuts?
He has the transportation manifest that will lead you to Oliver Carswell. It'll be encrypted, but I'll decode it if you snap me a picture.
Okay, so that's your man, Rongo, the guy in the red stripes. Between us and Rongo is
this guy.
A minefield. And I was just quickly looking around this shack to see if there was any medkits. I never bothered to do that before. You can actually use this as a zipline just to get down there quicker. And I want to do takedowns of both of these guys to save ammo. I want to save every last bullet I can. It's possible to do takedowns on him. Need to just distract him with a rock. Get him to turn around. They turn around.
What?
Take down on that guy. And this guy was just about to clobber me. You see that?
If you go slow.
You snooze, you lose. Didn't get away with it. So that came off, no problem. Now, to get to Rongo without blowing yourself to pieces, and quickly, I just like to hook around the left side here and go along this dirt path here, and I've gotten used to where the mines exactly are. Okay, so you just kind of hook over there a little bit. See, there's one there, and then there's two more flanking you. If you can spot them, then you're going to see there's one there and there's one there. So you just go right in between.
Okay.
And that's it. You
nice
made
and
it.
Slow.
Hook up with Rongo.
Agent Willis Huntley, asked me to extract you. He said you could help me find one of my friends. Tell me where Oliver is.
No, I need to go to the village now. I'll tell you when we get there.
Make them run.
What the hell? Fine, follow me.
So Rongo has told us his last name is Dickaround. And now it's just game on. And basically the best thing you can do is follow Rongo, because he does actually know where the mines are. So go exactly where he goes. Right there. And go up to that. This right here is cover right here, okay? I didn't go exactly where he went, but you know, I've gotten used to where he normally goes. So this is great cover here. Go for headshots. As much as you can. Keep the cover. There's no time limit. The next spawn is a kill trigger, okay? So when you kill a certain number of enemies here, then Rongo takes off. So you can take your time, there's no time limit. So that's the key, okay? Okay, so we've done the kill trigger. See, Rongo's taking off. See, so this is like spawn two.
That's right, up the hill, come!
Now at this point, you gotta kinda like take the lead. And, this is, I got lucky here. I really got lucky.
Have to go around, follow me.
This is something, you know, every time I do this mission, eh, normally, I don't know why, it's always night. And I find myself complaining to myself, why can't I ever do this mission during the day? And for once, I get the mission during the day, but what happens is the sun is right in my eyes. You see that? So I'm getting a lot of glare. That's why I tried to tag those guys there, so I could see exactly where they were. But I'm doing okay. I know that there's just a couple guys left in there. If I just take my time and pick them off slowly, I'll be okay. As long as they don't surprise me. I can't really see where they are, but I'm depending heavily on the mini-map, the red dots in the mini-map.
Get the documents. Keep
so on. That's it, they're all dead. And forget about Rongo and his house right now. The top priority right now is to reload, to ammo up, because the next part you're going to need lots of ammo. And you're not going to be able to come back here again.
Where is it?
Okay, so my PKM is ammoed up. Now it's like lay the mines as quickly as possible. There's lots of mines in here for free. Grab the med kits. Lay one down here, just like my master difficulty run. Lay another one on the other side. This is going to help out a lot.
Hurry up! I cannot find the document.
And now the first batch always comes from the west, from the road down there. Okay. And I'm depending once again heavily on the mini map, the red dots on the mini map. This is my makeshift enhanced perception. That's where I figure out where the enemies are. And this spawn always blow that barrel there, and I miss them. They got by the barrel, so now I gotta gun them down one by one. This guy's running around, he's gonna get blown by the mine. Keeping an eye on him just in case he makes it by the mine.
Me.
All my things.
Taking
a
chance now, reloading, because the PKM reloads so slowly.
Get those assholes out the house!
Don't hear them! Don't let me die!
Short controlled bursts. Even with the PKM, doing everything to conserve ammo.
Drop him!
I know this guy over there. Going for headshots too, still. No spray and pray here. I'm taking a chance on reloading. I can see them moving in there, freaking out. So now this is like getting near the end of the protect the house part, so I'm starting to like use ammo a little more recklessly.
I'm gonna fuck you up.
Oh my God. And I knew that propane tank was there. I think that guy shot that explosive barrel himself. And then when you hear Rongo say, come here, that's it, it's all over.
Okay, come in.
But I just want to see if there's any ammo left. There is, so this is great. Get to ammo up the PKM, because I'm going to be using that later on in the game.
Hey, come here.
And I don't want to rely on this this theory I have that your weapons will reload.
I found
if you leave
them, the transportation manifest.
In the guns for sale machine, like if you swap them out and then swap
it
out again.
Finally.
After fast traveling, I don't know exactly what the criteria is, but they will reload. I haven't figured out exactly what the criteria is. So that's it. A man named Hoyt Down, I survived.
Wills,
and,
you got the picture?
The pirates use codes Neanderthals can read. Oliver's being transported on the old road. I've sent the decrypted coordinates.
Good! I'm on my way!
Next is saving Oliver. So I'm just making sure the mission actually updated. And then it's off to the Manicky Outpost. That's the best way to drive to that location. For this, you don't need any weapons at all, because the game provides you with weapons. Basically, it's like it's a protect the NPC mission, and then a rail shooter in the boat with Oliver. So I'm not even bothered swapping out weapons. Just take the PKM along with me. And this drive, okay, it may look like I don't know what I'm doing, but I'm actually going off-road. I have a really good idea of exactly where I'm going. So it looks pretty helter-skelter, but when I go off-road, I have a pretty good idea of exactly where I'm going. And I'm going off-road to save time, just to kind of like get to the objective, like, you know, as the crow flies, instead of like, you know, driving on the road like a normal human being. Truth be told, here's true confessions time. Okay, did you guys know that this ramble run is what I actually originally planned as my Far Cry 3 project? Okay, this is what I originally planned. This project I've had since right since I first started playing Far Cry 3. I had it in mind to do this, some kind of ramble run. Like, I had barely finished one quarter of the game when I came up with this idea. And I wanted to do this originally, and then a lot of you, at least half a dozen of you, were posting comments saying, "Slack, I bought Far Cry 3, but I'm not gonna like start playing it until you do a walkthrough." And so many of you had like posted comments like that I felt really bad. I said to myself, "I know, I better do a real walkthrough because
you know, get a vantage point before that exchange happens.
A lot of my viewers are gonna be really angry with me if I don't actually do an official walkthrough." So, I put the Rambo run on ice and, you know, worked on the real walkthrough and, of course, the field manual. And while we're on the subject, if you want to learn how to kick the game's arse just like Major Slack, check out my Far Cry 3 Master Field Manual. It's basically my Master Difficulty walkthrough in ebook format, 153 pages of original Slack. You want to see what it looks like? Check out the link in the video description for a free sample. Okay, so here we go. We're at the location.
That ledge looks perfect.
Of the Saving Oliver mission. Get up to this ledge and then the game takes control.
Where's Oliver? I better wait until I see him.
Now what's going to happen here is the game is going to give you a Z93, I believe, and it's going to lock you into scoped mode. The only thing you can do is zoom in and zoom out with the scope to give you a wider field of view. That's it. And I strongly recommend that you use that to your advantage just to keep an eye on all the enemies.
Him alone, assholes.
How many of you have gotten the glitch where Oliver doesn't run? He just stands there like a stone idiot. He just stands right up there behind that concrete block there, and he doesn't move. After you've, like, you know, shoot the guys, set the whole sequence.
Can't let them put Ollie in the chopper.
That annoys me to no end. So usually I like to wait until
on, Ollie,
he gets right near the chopper. And so he started running, so that's good. So he's on his way. Now it's just a matter of protecting Oliver while he makes his way down to the boat off to the far left there. Got to gun everyone down. Try not to miss. You got 5 shots before you have to reload. I can't believe that guy survived those 6 explosive barrels. See, so I'm scoping in and scoping out now. Two things you can do. Watch Oliver. Watch for his shooting. That'll give you an idea of where the enemies are coming from. And once again, scope in and scope out. Take advantage of any red explosive barrel you see. Another thing you can do is always reload while Oliver's running. That's your chance to reload. Take advantage of it. Typically, there's no enemies shooting at him when he reloads, because that means the enemies have been cleared. That particular spawn has cleared. I can't believe I missed that guy. I'm pretty sure he gets great. Something else. The ones that are closest to Oliver are your top priority. Any enemy close to Oliver is your top priority. Once again, I'm reloading as Oliver's running. Now this guy, he slams his rocket into you. He doesn't always spawn. As soon as you come out of the scope mode from the Z93, that's it, that's your cue. Dive into the water, get into the boat. Oliver thinks he's at a party.
Hey, nice tats,
man. Nice tats, man.
Let's get out of here.
You blithering idiot, drive the boat. We just escaped by the skin of our teeth. Now this part, I know all the spawns pretty well. So this is the only way I'm going to survive with barely any body armor and 2 health bars. Versus the boat or the barrel on the dock, then it's the boat from the left. Pretty much after the barrel on the dock that I just shot down, everything comes from the left until you get out to open water. And you got to blow a rocket launcher just to the left there. Just shoot there, even if you can't see him. He just popped off a rocket. But he missed me, so I'm good. And then watch a jeep coming from behind the bridge there. There's another boat here.
Trucks coming up on the road.
Go for the man, not the vehicle. Most particularly the gunner. You can get the gunner, don't worry about the driver. One more jeep from the left here, and then we're going to swing around to the right to get a boat. Got him. Swing quickly around to the right. There's going to be a boat coming up. After the boat is a chopper. So you got to take down the boat as quickly as possible. Look for the gunfire and shoot at the gunfire. Pretty sure I got him.
Shit, dude, helicopter! Chopper!
Go for the cockpit in the chopper. And it took him down pretty good. Watch this one. That's beautiful. And that's it. Once you take out those guys in the dock there, you pretty much made it. Celebrating.
Yeehaw!
Yep.
We did it. Saved me. And they're putting the screws to my dad. He was about to give them a ton of money.
Ollie, you would have been sold right into slavery afterward, even if he'd paid.
Oh, shit. Man, this is some heavy shit, man.
So now he finally grasps the gravity of the situation.
You're stronger than you think. Come with me. I have someplace safe to hide you.
A little slow on the uptake there, are you, Oliver? There you go.
He's a Daisy. I found Oliver.
Hey,
girls. Oh, it's good to be back.
So glad you're okay.
Oh, I'm as high as a kite and the greenhouse is on fire.
Wish we could play as Oliver.
What kind of place is this?
Wow.
That'd be cool.
This has got quite a kick.
I'd much rather play as Oliver than Jason.
I put it out.
How about you guys?
Hey, I'll be with you in a second. This place is like heaven.
Hey, Jason, when you have a sec, can you come over here? I have something to show you.
I got something to show you too. Come on.
I'm building a cross for Grant.
Thanks. Haven't really had time.
We have to talk.
We will. Just not now. I need to find Riley. If anything happens to that kid...
I miss you. Okay? And you're carrying all these weapons, and you have all these weird tattoos, and... I'm not saying you shouldn't go rescue them. I'm just worried it's affecting you.
Lisa, don't worry. I'm taking control of my life for the first time.
I know,
that's
you're
a
right.
good thing.
We've been working really hard on that, and I have a studio job waiting for you. I helped Steve.
Oh, look, I don't want to talk about your exes right now. All right, this is my path. I've got to find it on my own.
Okay. Okay. I get it. You're stressed out. We can meet up later. I love you. Now go. Before I try and stop you again.
And that is it. Thank y'all very much for watching. Join me next time when we take on more Far Cry 3 in the hardcore Rambo mode. And we start dicking around with Buck. Yeah. Yeah. And if you thought this video was remotely entertaining, hey, don't forget to give the old Slack there a thumbs up. Yeah. All right. That's it. Slack is it.